Rise and Shine on Australia's Vision Christian Radio.
It's Friday. It's a podcast. We've got things to do.
Yeah. We've people to see. We're very busy around here. One of the things that I'm very excited about, if you cast your mind back a couple of weeks, there was a sound of me cutting paper.
Yes.
And sticking papers together.
Yes.
That was me coming up with a new schedule plan to go through. I'm excited because we're racing out of the studio after Friday's show, heading upstairs with Robbo. He's going to pull out the Taskmaster whip and get us working on the schedule.
Can I say though?
Yeah.
It's October, right?
Mm.
Did you think maybe a bit late?
Well, you know, no, this is like getting ready for the new year.
Okay, well, if you say that, you're early. But if you say it's just got around to it.
I'm early.
What have we been doing all this time? Well,
I've been, you know, watching the schedule sort of falling apart for the last few months.
Well, you weren't here forever.
Exactly. I was away for 50 shows ago.
We just made our own schedule up at that.
Yeah. So we're basically doing a bit of an overview, having a look at how where everything's fitting together. And,
so if you've got any ideas.
Well, I've got plenty of ideas.
No, not you.
Oh, okay.
The people listening.
Yeah, exactly. My ideas, get them out of here.
No, look, if you've got some good ideas, we really need them. Let us know.
Yeah, let us know what you love, what you hate, what you know, we're always open for feedback. Best way to do that is over on the Facebook page and the Facebook group. Just search for Rise and Shine Vision on Facebook and away you go.
There you go. Look out for the mystery sound clue
coming
up soon.
Wait a minute. Are you telling me Vision's breakfast show is now available around the clock and on demand? Incredible. The Rise and Shine podcast. Rise and Shine.
From the Vision Christian Media Hub to your home or car or wherever you are, it's Rise and Shine with Fel and DJ on Vision.
That's right. It's Fel and DJ taking you into your Friday. It's always very, very exciting. And today it's Mixtape Friday, even better.
Let's you know, scrub the niceties and get straight into the music.
Are we not nice when we do that? DJ's like, it's all business here.
Yeah, like I get so excited about Mixtape Friday. It's one of my favourite times of the show and of the week. And if I say the artist Ben Fuller, does he ring a bell at all? No?
I think of a TV show I used to watch with the name Full in it.
Well, yeah, what, Full House? You're thinking of Full House straight away.
That's all I think of.
All right. Well, Ben Fuller is an artist that is, you know, he does a little bit more country. We have played one of his, he had a massive smash hit, I think it was last year, with Who I Am. Do you remember that Who I Am song?
Is it this?
That's it. You remember this one?
Yes. Yes. That's a really good song.
That's a great song. So Ben Fuller is a really a country music artist, and he's just released a brand new song. And I tell you, I've had this song replaying in my head all week since he got it released.
Okay.
It's called Black Sheep, and I'm dedicating this song to anybody out there who has gone through a season where they've been the black sheep of the family, or you might have one in your life right now. Listen to the lyrics here.
Just don't look at anyone.
No,
eyes forward, Australia.
Oh, this is a prayerful song. There's a line towards the end that I absolutely love. He says, "That amazing grace is a pesky, pesky thing."
Really? That's a cute line.
I love it. He talks about the hounds of heaven. I don't know if you've ever heard that expression.
Yeah.
Where the Holy Spirit is the hound of heaven that is just going to, you know, get onto that black sheep's heart. Beautiful country song. A little bit different for us here first thing on a Monday morning, but I thought we'd kick it off
Friday,
with this.
Well, it's Friday, isn't it? But we'll keep going. It's Friday morning, Mixtape Friday. Give us a call with your request.
Oh, boy.
Here it is. Ben Fuller, Black Sheep.
You broke through a thousand fences, been rescued from a thousand ditches. You still swear you don't fit in, so you kick and scream and you're gone again, wandering off into the devil's wind.
So good. Oh.
There you go.
That's been playing in my head. If you want to know what it's like in DJ's head,
I'm all good.
It's basically had Black Sheep Ben Fuller on high rotation.
It's about 3 days ahead of what it is.
Yeah,
so today's Monday in DJ's head.
Well, that's true.
The weekend.
That's true. I don't know where Friday went, but I'm already living in Monday. I'm in the future, everybody. I'm coming to you from the future.
It's very organised if you can do it 3 days ahead. But look, we are on Mixtape Friday, which means you get to send in your request. You can do it by text. You can do it by phone.
Mm-hmm.
I guess Courier Pigeon. We haven't had many turn up in the studio.
No, no.
And
smoke
signals. Get through a few doors to get to us.
Yeah, we haven't been up to the roof lately and checked how's things going there. But give us a call, 1-800-316-316. I can see we've got some people on the line now.
Oh, we've got our wonderful Ruth on the line. But Ruth, I hear you're not feeling well.
Yes, not feeling the best today.
I can hear the cold.
I know. Yeah.
I just got, look, if it's any consolation, it's going around everywhere.
Yes, I think so.
Mm-hmm. We've had a few people down in the office with some head colds as well. Well, is there a song that we can play you this Friday to help ease the cold?
Oh, yes. I wouldn't mind if you played, I think it's a new song, but it's taken from an old song, One Common called Life Won't, but in brackets it has It Is Well. So I think you'd be able to twig on that.
I love it.
Well, they're good words. Mm.
Okay, so sort of is it taking the lyrics from the old hymn "It Is Well with My Soul"?
Sort of.
Okay,
you have to listen and see.
I like it.
Ruth, well done.
Here we go. One Common Christian pop worship duo doing some great stuff with a brand new track here for Ruth. Ruth, we love your taste in music.
Thank you.
I've got stories I wish I didn't have to tell. I know you're for me, but God, it does feel like hell.
Getting you up and ready to face the day. This is Rise and Shine with Felon DJ on Vision.
And now it's time for a little clue for the
Bible Story Stand-Off.
Good to see you here looking for a clue for the Bible Story Sound-Off. All right, you super sleuths, going to give you another one today. This story is from the Old Testament. This story is from the Old Testament.
Rise and shine.
That is need to breathe. Oh. And if you hadn't guessed, the song is called Who Am I? Which they do mention a few times.
The thing I love about Need to Breathe is they've got that bit of a raw emotional voice. Like he's singing. He's got that bit of, dare I say it, a bit of rock emotion in the voice. You don't get a lot of that sometimes in Christian music. That's why I think they stand out. I mentioned that because I think we're going to hear about that again. But we're going to introduce you to some new music here. Now, listen, I've asked the computer technology here.
Well,
to come up with a Robbo on a bicycle down in the basement. To come up with a theme song, I told it needed to have mentioned Rise and Shine,
yes.
Felon DJ, yes. Vision Christian Radio,
oh,
and
excited.
New music. I did say,
yes.
Make it sound like an 80s new wave song.
Wow.
This is what I came up with. All right, so.
Okay, here we go. Come on, computer. Oh, goodness.
All right, yeah. I can feel it.
That's terrible.
Well. Music's here, turn it up loud. Okay.
Taking you higher. Well, it's a big promise from that. I think we might go back to the computer.
Yeah, I think computer try again is what we need to do with that one there. All right. But yeah, new music to Vision. Now, of course, you know the Vision Network is what you're listening to now. I call it Vision Prime or the Mothership.
The Mothership is what I heard, and
we've also got V180, which plays a little bit more younger style music, you know, a little bit more contemporary.
Teeny?
Yeah. Yep. Oh, well, you know, I love it. And I'm not a teen.
You know, or youth at heart.
Yeah, exactly. No, and then we also have, for the little ones, Vision Kids.
Which I love.
Yeah, well,
the youngest at heart.
Exactly. Mm. So new music is added to those platforms every week. And I thought we'd take a moment here on a Friday to have to check out some new music. The first one is by Stephen Stanley, one of my favourite young artists coming up at the moment. And this is where it all ties together. Mm. He's got that rock energy in his voice.
Does
He's got that bit of raspy voice there. The new song is called Not By Sight. And he was talking about it, I think, over his social media.
Mm.
This is what he had to say about it.
Not by sight, it's about looking around you and realizing that maybe everything's going to not be okay for a while. But that doesn't mean that it's going to be that way forever. Maybe reality isn't what it always seems to be. Maybe it's just temporary. And we have to push through.
Oh,
He's got that gravelly.
And he does have a good voice. But it does take you there, doesn't it? That the thinking behind the song is that if you're right now sitting in something, don't sit down and stop, but keep moving through it.
Because we walk not by sight.
Listen, faith and not by sight.
I love Stephen Stanley's voice. It's spelt with a PH if you're going to look for him online. Stephen Stanley, well worth checking out. Great young artist. Comes from a long line of pastors. He led worship in his church.
When you say PH, I'm thinking, where is the PH in Stephen? So it's S-T-E-P-H. And I'm like, Stanley? What a PH. What an odd guy. Yeah. Okay, sorry.
Like, I do it wrong every time. That's why I'm telling everybody. I always do it with a V. But Stephen Stanley, Not By Sight. This is the first time it's being played on Vision. Turn it up this morning. Here it is, your new music on your Friday.
I've got some tired eyes, living by night, nothing but dark signs. Why do I try? Why do I even try? I'll say I'm alright, but that's half a lie. You say the future's bright, so hang on tight. Maybe it's not by side.
That is Stephen Stanley, new to Vision. Actually, V180 is where you'll normally hear that one, Not By Sight.
Oh.
This is great. I love all this new music.
Look, Stephen Stanley, spelt with a PH. That's PH and Stephen. Stephen
not
Stanley.
Not in the Stanley bit.
Not in the Stanley. Stephen Stanley Music. If you search for Stephen Stanley Music, you'll pop up on all your socials, his website and everything there. Great young artist. Love the lyrics. Love that bit of rock energy that he brings to the scene here. Now, going in a slightly different direction, another new song that we've added to V180 is our favourites, Apollo Limited.
So if you're a bit of a NASA person, like my husband wanted to work for NASA.
Oh, well, then he's going to listen to his new favourite band.
This is basically it. Apollo. Yeah. CC Winans can step aside. Apollo Limited. They did actually name it after something to do with...
Well, the lead singer, Jordan Phillips, his uncle was literally an astronaut for the Apollo
thing. That is cool, isn't
it? So he grew up around that. And so it's a duo. Jordan Phillips on the lead vocals, Adam Stark doing all the behind the scenes stuff. Great songwriters. They've won a bunch of awards. They're based in Nashville. Their brand new song is called Breakthrough. Another fantastic hit for them.
And some really good words in it. So as you're listening along, there's some here. Hindsight 2020, so many blessings you had for me on the blind side was a story. How could I be finally seeing it now? Like looking back and going, isn't that important for building your faith?
Mm-hmm.
That idea that if we can look back and go, actually, you know what? I didn't realize it at the time.
Yeah.
But God was right there and he was blessing me along the way.
And this is where you get a bit of a, ready for this for the segue? This is where you get a bit of a breakthrough happening. This is Apollo Limited with their brand new song, Breakthrough. Listen to the lyrics. It's a great one. Turn it up this morning on Rise and Shine.
When I look back on my life of walking a row with no signs, I couldn't believe what I couldn't see, but God only knows how I tried.
That was Apollo Limited, Breakthrough. And I'm very pumping sort of a sound there. I love that.
We've had two big songs in a row there. So two new songs, maybe two new artists to you. Apollo Limited, we just heard with their new one, Breakthrough. And before that, Stephen Stanley, Not By Sight. Two new songs added over to V180. But you know what? If you request them over here on Vision, we might just play for you.
DJ definitely will.
Well, I will.
The other thing you'll be requesting is the news headlines, which we're running up to now.
Rise and shine with Fel and DJ on Vision.
Fel, I'm excited because we have got Joseph Park, the chaplain to Chaplains. I love that title.
That is
from Jericho Road here on the line with us. Good morning, Joseph.
Good morning. Thanks for having me.
Now, there's a reason why we've got you on the line and we're talking to you. But first, before people might have never heard of Jericho Road before, tell us about the organisation.
Well, Jericho Road is a Christian charity. It's a social service arm of the Presbyterian Church in New South Wales. And for chaplaincy, is a part of the program. Our vision is to demonstrate the amazing love and the gracious character of God by providing fresh hope and care to those facing trauma, grief, ill health, or incarceration, and also to the emergency service community as well, like police.
Wow, that is a lot of different groups of people. So can you tell us some of those different groups? So we're talking about people who are maybe in hospital, emergency mm-hmm. services. Did you say prisons as well?
Yeah, absolutely. So we place chaplains, first of all, public hospitals, mm-hmm. Large public hospitals around Sydney area. We place chaplains there to provide spiritual and pastoral care to the patients and their families and also to staff as well. And some of our chaplains sit within an ethics committee of the hospitals as well. So they do a whole range of stuff. And we have chaplains in prison. Currently, we have one in near Bathurst and one near in Greater Western Sydney. And they just almost live there.
Wow.
40 plus hours a week, just hanging out with inmates, providing chapel services, but also one-on-one counselling, lifestyle groups, things like the Salvation Army provides a different sort of programs, and they run all those things, as well as, you know, just taking them out for community visits and things like that as well, and supporting their families too. And we have a senior chaplain who works with a police community. He visits all the way, Broken Hills, Dubbo, and places like wow. that, visiting Coffin stations, also appointing volunteer police chaplains as well.
Wow.
And we have some volunteer RFS chaplains and ambulance chaplains as well. So a whole range of stuff.
That is incredible.
You have totally got us on the back foot here, Josie, because I was expecting to go, yeah, we've got three or four guys working around a couple of prisons, but you are everywhere there with the Presbyterian Church. God bless you guys. There's one particular story. We saw a video of you interviewing, have I got it right, a former inmate called Phil.
Yeah, that's right. Phil, incredible story of God's amazing love that reaches behind bars. Mm. Phil's story came to us through one of our chaplains who supported him near Bathurst. And Phil was there for a number of years. And through his time with our chaplain team, he became Christian. He not only became a Christian, he became so committed to following Jesus. When I met Phil in the community, he's been out in the community for a number of years. He was just really on fire for the Lord, and he was really really. It was just a blessing time for me to be spending time with him, because he was basically saying how God had transformed him through some of the most darkest moments of his life.
Mm.
And he made it so clear to us why we need chaplains, and not just any chaplains, because unfortunately, from government's point of view, chaplains can be any religion. It can be Buddhist, it can be Hindu, it can be anybody, even atheists, humanist chaplains are coming along at the moment as well. Wow. But why we need Christian chaplains in public institutions like prisons and hospitals, other, because we know that the hope that we have in Jesus is far better than any hope. It's beyond cure. It's beyond anything, freedom. So Phil was able to encounter hope of Jesus through our chaplain team. And that's such a great story. We wanted to get that story out there to tell people about what God is doing in hidden places like prison.
We'll put the video up on our socials and make sure everybody's got a chance to see it. There's one aspect of Phil's story that I really, really love, but we'll get into that next. Here we've got Joseph Park from Jericho Road with us on Rise and Shine.
Rise and Shine.
Joseph Park is still with us, the chaplain to chaplains. What a great title. From Jericho Road there, the Presbyterians in New South Wales. Joe, so good to have you with us. We were talking about Phil and this amazing story of him as a man who was a non-Christian in prison, hearing, you know, the gospel message coming out, and you were telling us about how on fire he is in the community for the Lord. But one aspect I love in looking through it is that Christian radio has been a part of his journey. Flesh that out a little bit for us.
Well, in prison, guys have a very limited interaction with sort of social media and other things like that.
Yes.
And it's during the chapel service that Tim was able to play some songs, Christian songs. And Phil didn't grow up listening to Christian songs every now and then when he was a young boy and things like that. But it was on this particular chapel that he heard a Christian song play through Christian radio that it really just transformed his heart towards God. And I think it's the power of such a media like radio that brings Christian songs and hymns and stories to people. And it's a sort of a reaches through all borders, even through prison bars. And I think from then on, Phil really sort of brought all these, you know, influences through radios and songs and chapels and interactions with chaplains. And that really sort of solidified his faith in Jesus. And he continued that even while he's living out in the community, that he's a very on fire for Jesus. He listens to Christian radio all the time. And I think that's bringing a lot of encouragement to him.
Oh, that's fantastic. That's
amazing.
Fantastic.
Well, Joseph, we're all inspired this morning by the work that you guys are doing out in places that we will never be able to reach personally. But it's exciting to know that this month, and I'm sure all the time, but particularly this month, there's a focus on what we can do to help your organisation. Can you tell us a bit about that?
Yeah, October appeal is we set aside this month to really focus on raising awareness of Christian chaplaincy in public places. So chaplaincy has been around for many, many years. Government is supporting hospital chaplaincy, police chaplaincy, and corrective service chaplaincies. And, you know, you probably heard of the defense chaplaincy as well, which is quite big and historically well-respected. But in civil space, government provides funding, but the funding is never enough. We as a charity and the Christian denomination, we chip in to cover the full cost of employing our chaplains. Guys like Phil, it is work of God, but God uses his people to bring his message to people. And so it wasn't a coincidence that Phil got to meet Tim, and Tim became his mentor, his pastor, while he was behind bars. And we can only place Tim if our funding is sustained and supported. So that's why we are asking people to consider praying for us and consider giving for this Christian ministry, because it is what God is doing behind bars, and everyone can be part of this. And as you mentioned, Phil, without permission, without authorization, no one can just rock up into a prison and share the gospel. No one can actually go to hospital behind intensive care where I used to work and just rock up and tell people about Jesus. You need permission, you need authorization, you need vaccinations, you need all that sort of stuff. But we have the opportunity, we have the people, they are well-trained, committed Christians in places where others can't go. So this is like a mission work. And this is like sending missionaries to Saudi Arabia. So this is really important work, and we would love everyone to be part of this appeal. Raising $30,000 is our target. This year we have about $100,000 gap in our funding. We've raised about $50,000 so far. We need to do more to reach our $100,000 target. And this month we're trying to raise $30,000. So please get involved with that, please.
Joseph, I'm so impressed that the costs are so small. Like the fact that you're wanting to raise, you know, the gap of $30,000, I thought it was going to be a lot more to do the work that you're doing. So the way that you're able to stretch a dollar with what you're doing with Jericho Road is such a blessing. I'm going to tell everybody, go to jerichoroad.org.au. We're going to put the links, the videos, all the information up on our social media there, but jerichoroad.org.au. When you go there, you'll see right there Phil's story, a place to be able to click to be able to give towards this amazing work of prison chaplaincy, but not just prison chaplaincy. As you said, Joseph, the chaplain to chaplains, you are,
intensive,
you know,
care
everywhere.
It's
everywhere.
Amazing.
Thank you. It's such a privilege, the work that I do. And I mean, I worked as a 6 years as a hospital chaplain, and I saw what God is doing behind bars, behind prisons, behind, you know, police stations, and behind intensive care and the emergency services. And I think this is such a good and noble work that we can be part of. And I thank you so much for the opportunity to talk to your listeners about our work today. Thank you.
We just thank you so much, Joseph, for coming on and chatting to us. come back. I think we'll have to have Joseph back.
100%.
Because he's got so many stories. It's so inspiring. And faith building, which is what we're all about. Look, if you want that website again, is jerichoroad.org.au. And you can jump on there and get involved with their appeal over the month of October.
It's the best way to start your day. Rise and shine with Fel and DJ on Vision.
I'm a bit excited because I feel like I could get my Irish accent on.
There's always an excuse.
I feel like we've got someone new in the studio with the world's best accent.
Well, we do. We have a man with a real accent, and it's a fantastic accent.
Oh, come on.
Our good friend Matthew Cliff, Liverpudlian originally. Oh, how's
right.
that?
That's right.
That's what you're correct.
That's what you call someone from Liverpool in the UK.
You do, but to be even more precise, we're called Scousers.
Ah.
So, but anyway.
It doesn't sound quite as good.
It doesn't sound quite as good, no, but there you go.
Stick with the Pudlian. What was it?
Good. So the Liverpool accent is that fantastic, I mean, made famous obviously from the Beatles, you know, doing that, you know, that Beatles sort of drawl there, but it's that weird mix of UK and Ireland and a few different places all in there. It's great.
So I was just saying then, obviously, with the Liverpudlian accent, there's so many Irish in Liverpool that they call it the capital of Ireland.
Okay.
So there you go.
Well, there you go.
Matthew, you're encouraging her. No. Well, listen, Matthew Cliff, so good to have you here. You've been here before.
Yeah.
Friend of Vision, friend of the show. And you are the CEO of cherishlife.org.au. Cherish Life, I just call it like the pro-life champion group for Queensland.
Aww. We'll take that.
How would you describe it?
Yeah, so look, we are a pro-life organisation, probably be known as that, but we look to do two things, to be honest. We look to educate people, all people really, on pro-life issues, and we look to advocate on your behalf and the people's behalf to the powers that be to see the kind of laws that we want to have in this nation. So that's kind of our goal really. Pro-life organization, sums it up.
And that covers everything from, you know, the start of life to the end of life.
That's right. Yeah.
Okay. And everything there.
Yeah.
And we're in an election in Queensland
at
the moment. So anyone who's listening in Queensland, just in case you didn't know, you are need to get out to vote.
I've seen more signs than ever before, I think.
The rest of the nation will follow. There are always elections that pop up. But in Queensland at the moment, where Cherish Life is based, you've got quite a big job you're doing.
Yeah, we've got a lot on. Bit of a chaos time at the moment. I mean, there's 93 electorates in Queensland.
Okay.
So that's a lot of work. Obviously, every electorate probably has about 5 candidates.
Mm.
So it's a big job. But yeah, we just got to target and be as precise as we can. And we kind of try to do general stuff as well to educate the public.
Well, that's an interesting one, though, isn't it? What do you see your role as? It's an election. You're talking about candidates. You're obviously not running.
No.
What do you see your job as in that sort of environment?
Yeah, well, look, our organisation obviously has lots of supporters. And my heart and my job, I see it, is just to educate them on what's going on in the state and, you know, to point them to their pro-life candidates. I get phone calls, emails every day saying, who do I need to vote for?
Wow.
Where does this person stand on this issue?
Mm.
And that's why we exist, to do that education work, really.
Wonderful. So you can make an informed decision as a voter.
Yeah. And I can see right here, I've just gone to cherishlife.org.au, your website. We're going to put the link out there on our socials. And the first thing that pops here, find out what candidates in your electorate are pro-life.
Yep.
So you've got a big button, click here. It's about half the size of the website there. You can't miss it. And what happens when I click into that? For Queenslanders who want to know about this issue, what happens when you click into that?
Yeah, so look, you put your postcode in and basically what will happen is that'll tell you exactly where your candidates stand on this issue. So we've reached out to all the major parties we've reached out to. They've responded. Some of them have responded individually. But also, look, that'll be updated daily. So any independent candidates, we're still kind of updating there, obviously, due to the massive scale of the electorates. But yeah, look, the major parties, their information is on there. And they'll be able to tell you, basically, the question we've asked them is where they stand on abortion after 22 weeks.
Wow.
That's what we've asked.
Because that's the bills that are in the Queensland, going through the Queensland Parliament and everything at the moment.
Well, we haven't got a bill, any legislation going through. What the bill that's just recently gone through is called the Babies Born Alive Bill. And that's for babies that are born alive after an abortion. And that generally happens after third trimester abortion. So after 22 week stage. And we just want, look, we're asking people personally, the candidates, where they stand. We're not asking about legislation. We're not saying, look, are you going to bring a law in or anything like that?
Yes.
at this moment in time, we just want to know where you stand on it.
Yeah.
That's it.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, Matthew, can you stick around?
Yeah.
We're going to have a go. Shall we, DJ? We'll log on
to sheriff.org.au.
Yeah, yeah,
right.
We'll listen to some music. We'll come back and we'll see how it all works.
Rise and show.
And we're moving over onto the browser here on the website because we've got Matthew Cliff, our CEO of cherishlife.org.au. This is the Queensland organisation for pro-life issues. Now, you represent everybody in Queensland, but there are other organisations in every state around Australia.
Yeah, there's some amazing organisations. So, look, there's national organisations. So, Joanna Howe, obviously, would be more national. Joe does amazing work.
Yes.
Love Australia in Adelaide as well. Right to Life groups in New South Wales, Victoria. So, yeah, there's a few of us.
Yeah. Well, if you go right now, and for the Queenslanders who are listening, if you go to cherishlife.org.au, and I've just done it, it took me all of about 3 seconds to do, pop my postcode in there and ask me which my electorate is, and then it tells me what candidates are there and how they've responded with the question that you've asked them about this particular bill that's been floating around.
Well, it's not a bill. It's this particular issue, which is, so where do they stand personally on abortion after 22 weeks.
And some of them I can see here, I've gone through with mine, my candidates. Some are a yes, some are a no, and some are they haven't got back in contact with you or they haven't answered the question directly.
Yeah, that's right. So look, what we've had, some of the candidates have answered us directly.
Mm-hmm.
What's happened, as happens with politics, is the party will answer for them.
Oh, yes.
So we've kind of had a generic response from the party. So then we've just put it up there. So, and that, again, that's how it works sometimes. But we've definitely had also some individuals who've got back to us. And look, like, so Family First, for example, Qatar, they would get back to us personally.
Mm-hmm.
The kind of the major parties, the Labour's and the LNP, kind of sent generic responses.
Okay, but if someone is listening along, that's fantastic because I love being informed when you're going to vote.
Yeah.
And even if you're a young person, I've got my daughter's turning 18 next year and she's saying, Mum, how am I going to know what to vote for? It's about educating yourself and becoming informed about big decisions that are on your heart and where your candidates are going to vote on those. But it's great. You're actually running some additional sessions where I guess people can ask more questions about what's involved.
Yeah, so look, we obviously do the political stuff, which is this is a tool for this season, really.
Yes, sure.
But my heart really is to try and do the education work. That's the goal.
Yes.
So we've got a few events. Well, we've got a few seminars coming up. We've done two already in Mackay and Springwood. And then next week we've got Redcliffe, Narang, and I'm in Rocky.
Okay, so what would we expect if we came along to the seminar?
Yeah, so that's a Christian perspective on abortion.
Mm-hmm.
You can make a scientific case against abortion, a kind of rational case against abortion. But yeah, this is particularly aimed at churches and trying to inform Christians on, you know, helping them navigate the complexity of this issue.
Oh,
yeah,
wonderful.
It's a minefield. I can't believe that it's become such a hot topic
in
the West, you know, in the US at the moment with the elections. Number one issue that their candidates are being asked.
It's so good, though, that at the moment, and I can see in Australia, and Joanna Howe, I've been following along on social media,
amazing.
Huge this week in South Australia,
but
wonderful to see discussion around it and to say, hey, there is another perspective to perhaps the narrative that we've been sold for so long, and let's get educated and understand it before, you know, and some wonderful Christian perspective. So thank you for what you're doing.
No problem.
Yeah. If churches want to get involved or people want to get you involved, cherishlife.org.au, and we'll give you these dates again, right? If you're in Redcliffe, this coming Tuesday, the 22nd of October, going to be at the Siebel, Brisbane, correct?
Yeah.
Wednesday in Narang, so that's the 23rd of October at Highway Church, and at Rocky and Yeppoon on Thursday. You're a busy boy, Matt.
But he's going to sleep after
that. Yeah, he's going to sleep there at Peace Christian Church on the 24th of October. Yeah. We'll put the dates out there.
Yeah. Great.
But hey, in the midst of the, as you said, the chaos season, thank you so much for popping in here and letting us know.
Thank you, guys. Thank you for having me.
Oh, anytime.
Sure. Anytime you want to bring your accent in.
Open door for Liverpool and everywhere.
Just the right mix of things to inspire and things to make you smile. Rise and shine with Felon DJ on Vision.
We have a wonderful cast of characters here of the Vision family around Rise and Shine. One of our beloved ones is Mama Carol in Sydney with her cat named Lady Cat that she walks around on a lead. Incredible. And she is such a wonderful woman, you know, turning 74 by herself, a widow, no kids there, living at home. And we found out that yesterday that she had a bit of an accident. This is what she had to say.
We've got Carol on the line. Oh. And our lovely Carol, you've been in the wars. You've had a trip and a fall and you've hurt your hand. Are you okay?
Yeah, thanks be to God, I am. Yes, I actually cut my hand.
Ugh.
I sliced it like a knife.
Oh,
cut,
dear.
And it a flap of skin like an open door came off because I cut it on a wrought iron thing.
Oh.
And
is this at your home in Sydney?
Yeah, this is in my home at Sydney. Oh. And I put the flap back over. Yeah. And then I rang a friend that I knew, and she took me to hospital there for 6 hours.
Oh.
And they took x-rays and so on, and then they had to soak it with the saline solution for about half an hour, and then she had to scrub that congealed skin off the raw flesh.
And I was digging
my fingernails into and curling my toes. It was quite painful.
Man.
And I said to the nurse, Jesus suffered more on the cross for us.
Cheap.
And it all came because there was a wrought iron railing and she was telling us there's some steps up to her patio and she'd grabbed onto it from the ground and it just come out done all this damage.
She has sent me the photos of her rusty old railing there and it's a nightmare. It's an accident waiting to happen. And look, we've told the story out there and I'm hoping that someone can help. Well, Abraham from Fairfield in Sydney, the wonderful Abraham, zipping around doing his deliveries today. Abraham, you've given us a call, mate.
I certainly have, and I've heard a wonderful story, well, in a bad way, but in a good way that we can help.
Mm.
I'm willing to help her with a group of boys.
Oh.
'Cause being a mother, I can't sympathise in regards to being a mother, but I can sympathise the pain that she's been through.
Yeah.
And the good thing about my boys, they've got to learn about life. Life, you got to help someone out.
Yeah, yeah. Awesome.
Go on, sorry.
No, you're right. Abraham, we're so touched that you're willing to do this with the boys there. Well, listen, what I'll do, if it's okay with you, we're going to grab your details, we'll get Carol's details, and we'll put you two together and see if we can't work out something there.
Oh, of course, it's no problem. I can call her out for her and we'll get it wrapped up. And at the end of the day, I want to make her happy.
Oh, now is there any payment that Carol can do for you and the boys there?
Just coffee and biscuits.
Okay. Coffee and biscuits and a good chat. I think she can totally do that. Abraham, you're an absolute blessing. Thank you so much for giving us a call.
Well, I like the fact of how Jesus always helps everyone. So if he can heal someone in a good way, not just by spiritual healing, but even a physical healing, we're going to do the same thing.
Oh, bless you heaps.
Amazing.
Bless you heaps, Abraham. Amazing. All right, we'll grab all the details and we'll put the two together. We might even see if we can't get Carol on the line in just a moment.
Rise and shine. Text your favourite song to 0447 488 316 and we'll play it for you. It's the curtain call on Rise and Shine.
That's right. This is the time of the day where we let you choose a song to take us into our day. But we were just talking to Abraham with his very kind offer for Carol. So we've got Carol on the line. Carol, how you doing?
I'm doing pretty well in Jesus.
Yeah, well, we just heard a bit of a replay there of what happened to your hand on your railing at home there in Sydney. Well, listen, we put the call out there, and I know you haven't heard this yet because you've had a busy morning, but Abraham, our good friend who's a delivery driver around Sydney, has heard your story and has told us that next Saturday you've got a date with Abraham and one of his sons as they come over to try to fix that railing for you.
Oh,
that would be wonderful.
So we're gonna, if it's okay with you, we might be the middleman in the middle. We're gonna chat to Abraham and yourself and put you two in connection together to get that horrible railing fixed.
So, thank you. So, is that the 2nd of November, is it?
No, it'll be... No, now you're checking me. No, not this Saturday. The Saturday after, which is the 26th of October.
Okay, I'll put that in. That's lovely.
Oh, praise God. Well, we can't wait to hear about... You know what? Well, we've got you though, Carol, because we've all been praying for you. Is there a song or maybe just an artist that we can use to... Bring everyone, you know, that keep their eyes on Jesus, which is what you're so good at doing. Is there someone we could play for you?
Yes. Look, I love many, many singers, but I'm a bit overwhelmed. So I'm just thinking of Keith Green.
Oh, yes.
Yes.
And it's Run to the Highway.
Run to the End of the Highway.
Oh,
yes.
Carol, gee, very good.
Well done. Well, this is a song after your own heart. Now, I do have to let you know, before we say goodbye and listen to the song, Abraham and his son said there is a cost to fixing the rail,
yes.
And that is some tea and biscuits and a good story. Can you do that?
Yes, okay. I can do that.
Oh, bless.
All right. Well, if it's okay with you, Carol, we'll make all that happen in the background. But bless you heaps. We love you so much.
Thank
we don't
you.
Want you to get hurt again on that railing. Here it is going out to everybody for Carol Keith Green. Run to the End of the Highway. Your curtain call.
Well, you can run to the end of the highway and not find what you're looking for. The wind won't make your troubles disappear. And you can search to the end of the highway and come back no better than before to find yourself. You can run to the end of the highway.
Haven't heard that for a while.
Keith Green.
That's great.
Run to the End of the Highway, in case you're wondering. He does say it a few times.
Yeah.
But sometimes you're not sure what the name of the song is. That is going out to Carol, and we're so thankful for Abraham and our Vision family.
Yeah.
That's what we do best, isn't it? Like, I just love the connections and those God moments.
Totally.
We're very thankful for Abraham, and he's saying, my sons, I'm training them up to be helpful.
Yeah. This is a little bit behind the scenes. Abraham's got two sons here, and Abraham and Sydney. We're not talking about the biblical son. And he says, listen, one of them's really smart, one of them's really strong.
Well,
which one should I take to the job?
I am sure they're both smart and strong.
Yes, exactly.
If they're listening along, we think you're both awesome.
It sounds like together, they're the perfect team together with Abraham they're overseeing. Look, this is what it's all about, making real connections here, and we love this. So thank you to everybody who's been praying for Carol and reaching out there, and especially massive thank you to Abraham. We'll keep you all updated. Looks like next Saturday is the date where it's happening, so Carol will be getting the tea and biscuits ready.
Well,
the boys
got a week to get it together. Very exciting. Well, it is time for us to hand over to the rest of the Vision crew to take you into the rest of your Friday.
Yeah, have a wonderful Friday, a fantastic weekend. I will be telling you all about it next week. This is the final pain holiday where it's myself, my wife, Benita, and our three boys before my big boy gets married. So it's just the five of us one last time to get away together as a little holiday.
Aww.
We'll be doing it this weekend. I'll try not to shed too many tears, but I'll tell you about it on Monday.
Well, that's all from us. Bye.
Thanks for taking time to listen to this audio on demand from Vision Christian Media. To find out more about us, go to vision.org.au.